Angar, eco-luxury homes with resort-style living. Chaturthi special offer, pay no GST and semi-furnished apartment. Project located near Mopa Airport, Dadamark.
Hello and welcome to In Goa 24/7. I'm Rosario with today's top story. Today is Teachers' Day, and on this day, students pay their respects to their teachers by giving them gifts as sweet as a rose. Teachers are worshipped as God and students bow down to their wisdom. However, what happens when those teachers use their God status to their advantage, take on the role of the devil and do harm upon their pupils? Here's a disturbing story of a teacher who abused his God status to carry out the work of the devil. A video has surfaced of a swimming coach, Surajit Ganguly, who has molested a 15-year-old minor in Mapsa. Take a look. Video went viral. There have been a lot of questions raised over the appointment of coaches to the Sports Authority of Goa. When In Goa 24/7 investigated this matter, the Sports Authority of Goa washed off their hands, claiming that this appointment was not done via Sports Authority of Goa, but done through the Goa Swimming Association. Let's hear what V.M. Prabhudesai has to say.
The coach, Mr. Surajit Ganguly, he is a coach belonging to Goa Swimming Association. He has been specially brought by the Goa Swimming Association. And the president of the Goa Swimming Association and the honorable opposition leader has just spoken to me, conveying to me that they have terminated his services right away after hearing the news. So they have taken immediate action against the coach, and inquiry will go on.
Is there any police complaint lodged against the said coach?
No, we wouldn't know. We wouldn't know because it is for the Goa Swimming Association to see. He is their coach.
Okay.
He is not the Sports Authority of Goa or Sports Department coach. So he is the private coach, though he has been an employee of railways. At the moment, perhaps he has come on leave, long leave, and he has been training the state-level swimmers for a pretty long time. So his services are terminated. That is very important. And inquiry will go on.
Sir, a couple of months back, an RTI activist also had revealed the illegalities in the recruitment process of these coaches in SAG, wherein the due process was not followed to take in these coaches.
No, I am once again saying that he was not a SAG coach. So where is the question of illegalities? He is not a SAG coach.
Okay.
So you are misrepresenting. He was a coach brought by the Goa Swimming Association.
Okay. Also, couple of months back, Deputy Director of Youth Affairs, Sports and Youth Affairs, has clearly alleged that one of the coaches of SAG, table tennis, is also misbehaving with girls. And that time there was no action taken on that coach also.
Couple of months back.
Yes.
Yeah. The sports department coach?
Yes.
So you will have to ask the sports department officers.
Okay.
I have not been with the sports department for last 8 months or so.
In Goa 24/7 has consistently raised questions on the recruitment processes in SAG while recruiting staff and other personnel. But no action has been taken over this. We have an RTI activist who has been following up with the recruitment issues of SAG, who exposed that due process for recruitments was not followed as per guidelines.
As per the information received under RTI, it has been shockingly disclosed that huge number of personnel have been appointed illegally without following the due procedure by the Sports Authority of Goa. Now, any appointment in the government departments requires some basic procedures and character verification is a very important part of this procedure. Now, in this whole scenario, since no of the procedures have been followed, the question arises in my mind is whether this character verification has been done. Are the people, women working here who have been employed, are they working in a secure environment? Are the students, the young girls, are they secure in this training coaching camps, coaches, with the coaches? As a parent, do I feel secure to send my children to this camp? What security arrangement has been done by the sports authority to ensure the security of our children attending these coaching classes? I have never seen any security in the premises of the swimming pools, in the table tennis courts, in badminton courts, any other things where young girls are attending. I have seen no CCTV cameras, I have seen no provision of ensuring the safety of these attendees. So will the government, take a lesson from this incident? One very senior deputy director with the deputy director of sports and youth affairs has stated on record that there is one coach who has a predatory attitude towards the young girls and he is not confident of that coach. And so even the parents also have complained. But despite this certain and definite information available with the senior deputy director and which has been also shared with the director of sports authority of Goa, no action has been taken against this person. When the allegation itself is made by one senior person. So in this scenario, is the sports authority of Goa, the government of Goa, or directorate of sports and youth affairs is serious about the security of the children, of women coming to your premises? As parents, how do we feel now? Are we supposed to ensure our security? Are we supposed to be with them all the time?
Meanwhile, Minister of Youth Affairs and Sports Kiran Rijiju has taken cognizance of the issue and has promised stringent action via the Sports Authority and police to take strict penal action against the molester. Interestingly, in the year 2017, Goa Legislative Assembly had even moved a congratulatory motion congratulating Surajit Ganguly for bringing pride and glory to swimming and diving sports in the state of Goa.